Hello students, now I'm going to continue the chapter trigonometric functions of 12th standard. So in our first exercise we learn about how to find out the principal solution as well as the general solution. This was the first concept, and the second concept is to find out the Cartesian coordinates and polar coordinates. So first see what is the formula for these two and how to find out it. Now suppose I draw here the two Cartesian axis. The first one is the x axis and the y axis. This total system is called as the Cartesian system, and there is a point P having coordinates x, y, means this distance is x and this distance is y. So this point having the coordinates x, y, and these x, y are nothing but the Cartesian coordinates. Now if we join this point P to the origin, and this distance is r, and this r means this OP makes the angle theta with the positive x axis, then these r and theta, see here r and theta, so these are called as the polar coordinates of the point P. So first remember what is the polar coordinates and what is the Cartesian coordinates. So P x y, these are the Cartesian coordinates, and P r theta, these are the polar coordinates. Now see how to find out this r. So what is the formula for this one? Now see, this is a right angle triangle, and using Pythagoras theorem we are going to find out the value of r. So r square is equals to x square plus y square. So what is the value of r? R is root x square plus y square. So remember, you have to remember this formula for finding the r. R is the radius. And now in this triangle, same triangle, we are going to find out the sine theta. So sine theta, that is opposite upon hypotenuse. So we get here sine theta is equals to y upon r. And similarly the cos theta, that is adjacent side upon hypotenuse, so x upon r. So we take the cross multiplication. So here we get y is equals to r sin theta. You have to remember these formulas, and x is equals to r cos theta. So these three formulas are very important. R is equals to root x square plus y square. Next one, y is equals to r sin theta, and x is equals to r cos theta. So using this sin theta and cos theta, we also find out the value of tan theta by this formula, that is tan is equals to sin upon cos. Putting this value, so we get here y upon x, and the theta is equals to tan inverse y upon x. So this one is also one formula by which we are going to find out the theta. Next, for example, just we are taking one example. Suppose you have given this is 2 and pi upon r. So we have to convert this into Cartesian coordinates. So these are the polar coordinates, and we have to convert it into Cartesian coordinates. So we have to compare this with the polar coordinates, that is r theta. So r theta is equals to 2 comma pi upon r 4, means here the value of r is 2 and the value of theta is pi by 4. So we have the values of r and theta, and now so here we get the values of r is equals to 2, theta is equals to pi by 4, and now we are going to find out the value of x and y, means we are given r theta and we have to convert it into x and y. Now see, if we have the value of r, so r we can write like this one, that is x square plus y square, or we have to convert it into r theta, you have to convert it into x and y. So the value of x is r cos theta and y is r sin theta. So first we are going to write down this. So x is equals to r cos theta and y is equals to r sin theta. So what is the value of r? R is 2 cos theta. The value of theta is pi by 4. You know the value of cos pi by 4. It is 1 by root 2. So root 2. So this 2 we can write like this one. That is root 2 into root 2. So root 2 root 2 get cancelled. And so we get here answer root 2. And similarly we solve the value of y, and it is also root 2. So here we get the value of x and y, and the Cartesian coordinates is equals to x, y, which is root 2 comma root 2. Means in this example we are given polar coordinates and we convert it into Cartesian. And now we are taking the second example, that is Now we have given the Cartesian coordinates and we have to convert it into polar coordinates. So Pxy is equals to 1 upon root 2. Here also minus 1 upon root 2. So the value of x is 1 upon root 2 and the value of y is minus 1 upon root 2. Now see the r is equals to root x square plus y square. So we're putting this value in the root. Taking square will get half. So the value is root 1, that is 1. So here we get the value of r. Now we're going to find out the value of theta. So see, to find out the theta, which formulas are there? So y is equals to r sine theta and x is equals to r cos theta. So you learn this all, that is this is first quadrant, second, third and fourth. Here the both the coordinates having, if both coordinates are plus, then they lie in the first quadrant. In second quadrant -, third one -, and fourth one +-. Now see, our given point is 1 upon root 2 and minus 1 upon root 2. Means the first coordinate is positive and second one is negative. So our point lies in the fourth quadrant. So I put here this marking, that is our point lies in the fourth quadrant. And you have to mention it, that is our point lies in the fourth quadrant. This I write here, given point lies in the fourth quadrant. And you know that is, in first quadrant all the ratios are positive. In second one, sine and cosec are positive. Here tan and cot are positive. And in last, cos and sec are positive. Now we're just going to put down the values. So y is equals to 1 upon root 2. The value of r, we already find it, that is 1. And we're just putting the values of x and y here. So minus 1 upon root 2, 1 sine theta. Here also same, that is 1 upon root 2, the value of x is, r is 1 cos theta. So we get the sine theta is equals to minus 1 upon root 2 and cos theta is equals to 1 upon root 2. See here, sine theta is equals to, that is minus 1 upon root 2, and cos theta is equals to, cos theta is equals to 1 upon root 2. Now same, that is we learn in the first exercise, that is sine theta is equals to, we put this minus sine as it is. So which angle of sine having value 1 upon root 2? It is sine pi by 4. Same here, cos also pi by 4. Now see, sine theta is equals to, now we have to show this, that is minus sine theta, that is minus sine pi by 4. First we see this, that is cos pi by 4, but this angle jo hai, the jo angle hai, wo angle pi by 4, it does not lies in the fourth quadrant, because it is pi by 4 means it is 45 degree, and so it does not lie in the fourth quadrant. So theta is equals to pi by 4 is not possible, but we can write this like this one, that is minus sine pi by 4. So see here again, sine jo minus hai wo kaun se quadrant mein rehta hai, ek to third quadrant mein aur fourth quadrant mein. Yahan pe all positive rehta hai, sine second quadrant mein positive rehta hai, third aur fourth mein wo negative rehta hai. Means hame ye jo angle hai wo either third mein milega ya fourth mein milega, but our point lies in fourth quadrant, so we take the fourth quadrant, and in fourth quadrant we write the angle like, so you know this is zero. Here is pi by 2, here is pi, here 3 pi by 2, and this angle is 2 pi. And so to mention the angle in the fourth quadrant, we write 2 pi minus theta. So you learn all this. And here if we have to mention the angle in the second quadrant, we have to write pi minus theta. Here pi plus theta, and here pi, 2 pi plus theta. So our point is in the fourth quadrant, so we write the angle like this one, that is 2 pi minus theta. So here we write 2 pi minus theta. So theta is pi by 4. So we convert this negative into positive. So sine theta is equals to sine 2 pi minus theta. So taking LCM we get 7 pi by 4. And so comparing this, the theta is equals to 7 pi by 4. So our polar coordinates are r theta, r is 1, and theta is 7 pi by 4. So here listen it again. Cos theta is equals to cos pi by 4, means here we get the theta is pi by 4, but our angle means the theta is equals to pi by 4, but the given point we have given, point is 1 upon root 2 and minus 1 upon root 2, and it lies in the fourth quadrant, and this theta pi is equals to pi by 4, it lies in the first quadrant, so it's not possible, and so theta is not pi by 4, and so we solve this one. So we're going to start the exercise 3.2. So in this exercise, all the there are total 12 questions, out of which first and second question is on the Cartesian coordinates and polar coordinates, and from question number 3 to 12 it depends upon the properties of the triangle. So we going to solve the question number 1 and 2 now. So question number 1, so find the Cartesian coordinates and polar coordinates are given. So we have to find out the Cartesian coordinates, means we have to find out the x and y. So polar coordinates are given here, means we have to compare it with the r theta. So the value of r is root 2 and the theta is pi by 4. So first you know that is the x is equals to r cos theta and y is equals to r sin theta. So we have to put down the value of r is root 2 and cos theta, theta is pi by 4. And here also same pi by 4, and by solving it we get 1 1, and so the Cartesian coordinates is 1 1. Now the second example from question number 1. So 4 and pi by 2. So we have to compare it with the r theta, since they are the polar coordinates. R is 4 and theta is equals to pi by 2. So to find out the x and y, so you know the formula, that is x is equals to r cos theta and y is equals to r sin theta. Just we have to put down the values of r theta here, and we get the cos pi by 2 is 0, so the total answer is 0, and sin pi by 2 is 1, and so answer is 1, and so the Cartesian coordinates are x, y, that is 0 and 1. Same here. Now the third question from the question number 1. So 3 pi by 4 and 3 by 4 and 3 pi by 4 r theta. So the value of r is 3 by 4 and theta is equals to 3 pi by 4. So here we have that is x is equals to r cos theta and y is equals to r sin theta. Now see, x is as it is, the value of r is 3 upon 4, and here cos theta is 3 pi upon 4. Now see some changes is in this example. And same here, that is 3 upon 4 cos 3 pi by 4. Now see 3 pi by 4. So 3 pi by 4 means what? So 3 pi by 4 means the 3 into the value of pi is 180 upon 4. So 45 into 3. So we get here 135. Now see in which quadrant this angle lies. That is 135 lies in the second quadrant. Yes. So 0 to 90, 90 to 180 means this 135 lies in the second quadrant, and so here we have to write down the angle like pi minus theta, and so we're taking here that is 180. Pi means 180 minus 45. So if we subtract the 45 from 180, we get the 135. So we choose here 45. So 180 minus 45. So we write this angle like this one. So 3 pi by 4 we write like pi minus theta, that is pi minus pi upon 4, that is 45. We already solved it here, and hence the 3 upon 4 is equals to, so you know that is the cos pi minus theta is minus theta, and so we write here that is minus cos pi by 4. And so by putting the value, so minus 3 by 4 into 1 upon root 2, the value of cos pi by 4 is 1 upon root 2, and so by solving we get minus 3 upon 4 root 2. Similarly here we have to write down the same case is here. So sine minus pi by 4, here see that is cos pi minus pi by 4, we write here minus y, because the angle is in the second quadrant, and in second quadrant only sine and cosec are positive and cos is negative. So here we write the minus sign. Here sine pi minus theta. Now see, the angle is same in the second quadrant, but in second quadrant sine is positive, and so here we have tried on the plus sign. So 3 upon 4 into sine pi by 4. And so the 3 upon 4, the value of pi by 4 is 1 upon root 2, so y is equals to 3 upon 4 root 2. Hence the Cartesian coordinates are x minus 3 upon 4 root 2 and plus 3 upon 4 root 2. Now see the fourth example. I am going to give you this example for your homework. Just I am going to give one hint for this one, because this angle is ये एंगल जो आपको दिया है वो थोड़ा सा डिफरेंट है. सो मैं एक थोड़ा सा हिंट देती हूँ. सो हम ये कंपेयर करेंगे. सो द वैल्यू ऑफ आर इज हाफ एंड थीटा इज इक्वल्स टू 7π/3. नाउ 7π/3 इज 420. सो हाउ वी कैन फाइंड आउट इट? सो 7π/3 इट इज 420. सो वी पुटिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ 1π, दैट इज 180. सो 180 इंटू 3 डिवाइड करेगा तो 66 इंटू 7, दैट इज 420. So 420. So see here, where is this angle? 420. So here is up to 90, 180, 270, 360, and here. Means this angle lie in the first quadrant. And how we can write this? That is, if this angle is 2 pi minus theta, this angle is 2 pi plus theta. So here we write that is 2 pi plus theta. Now where to mention this angle, that is 420. So yahan tak 360 ho jata hai. उसमें कौन सा नंबर ऐड करेंगे तो 420 आएगा. सो 60, सो 360 प्लस 60, दैट इज 2 पाई प्लस थीटा. एंड सो वी यूज हियर, दैट इज 360 प्लस 60, दैट इज 2 पाई प्लस थीटा. सो आंसर इज कॉस पाई बाय 3, दैट इज 2 पाई प्लस थीटा इज कॉस पाई बाय 3 एंड साइन पाई बाय 3. एंड जस्ट वी हैव टू फाइंड दिस वैल्यू, दैट इज कॉस पाई बाय 3 इज हाफ एंड साइन पाई बाय 3 इज रूट 3/2. So similarly, and by the same way, you have to find out the answer of this one, that is Cartesian coordinates. So this example is for your homework. Now see the question number 2. So find polar coordinates, that is given is Cartesian coordinates. Cartesian coordinates आपको दिए गए हैं और आपको polar coordinates find out करना है. So root 2 and root 2, so these are the x and y. Now sir, इस सब examples में हमें ये ध्यान रखना है कि ये point कौन से quadrant में आता है. So since both the coordinates are positive, it lies in the first quadrant. यहाँ पे मैंने tick mark किया है. So point lies in the first quadrant. So you have to mention it in each example. And बाकी का को आपको सब पता है, that is plus plus, यहाँ पे minus plus, यहाँ पे minus minus, और यहाँ पे plus minus होता है. ये जो स्टेटमेंट है वो आपको हर एक एग्जांपल में लिखना है कि पॉइंट कौन से क्वाड्रेंट में आता है, क्योंकि ये अगर हमें पता होगा तभी हम थीटा फाइंड आउट कर सकते हैं. सो आपको एक्स एंड वाई दिया गया है. सो फर्स्ट एंड वी हैव टू कन्वर्ट इट इनटू आर एंड थीटा. सो फर्स्ट वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द आर एंड आफ्टर दैट वी विल फाइंड द थीटा. सो यू नो द फॉर्मूला ऑफ आर, दैट इज रूट एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वाई स्क्वायर. एक्स की वैल्यू है रूट टू एंड वाई की भी रूट टू. सो बाय स्क्वेयरिंग वी गेट रूट फोर एंड द आंसर इज 2. Now to find out the theta, so see, you know this formula, that is x is equals to r cos theta and y is equals to r sin theta. So x is equals to, x ki jo value hai wo hai root 2 is equals to 2 cos theta, r is 2. Similarly here I have to write down here. Now root 2 upon 2 is equals to cos theta, same here. Now we convert this 2 into root 2 into root 2, so cos theta will get 1 upon root 2 and sin theta also we get 1 upon root 2. And remember one thing, that is polar coordinates of theta, that is polar coordinate theta always lies in between 0 to 2 pi, means theta is always in between 0 to 2 pi, means it is less than equals to 2 pi and greater than equals to 0. Remember this one, means theta jo bhi hume milega wo 0 to 2 pi ke range mein hi milega. Now say cos theta. So which angle of cos having value 1 upon root 2, it is cos pi by 4. एंड ये जो दो हमें मिले हैं cos theta एंड sin theta, इसमें का कोई भी एक हमें सॉल्व करना है, ये दोनों सॉल्व करने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. सो cos theta इज इक्वल टू पाई बाय 4 एंड सो theta इज इक्वल टू पाई बाय 4 एंड सो द रिक्वायर्ड कोऑर्डिनेट्स आर r theta, द वैल्यू ऑफ r वी फाइंड इट दैट इज 2 एंड theta इज पाई बाय 4. नाउ सी द सेकेंड एग्जाम्पल, 0.5. सो द वैल्यू ऑफ x इज 0 एंड y इज हाफ. So r is equals to root x square plus y square. Here is 0 square and half square. So the by solving it is half. Now see, both the coordinates are positive. So the point lies in the, sorry, here the x coordinate is 0 means and y coordinate is half means the point lies on the y axis, that is positive y axis. Remember this one, the point lies on the positive y axis means point yahan pe kahin bhi hoga. Now see, x is equals to r cos theta and y is equals to r sin theta. So 0, we putting the value of x, that is 0 half cos theta, and here half is equals to half sin theta, so sin theta is equals to 1. So cos theta is equals to 0 we get here. So which angle of cos having value 0, that is pi by 2. So see, here we get the pi by 2, that is it is on the y axis, and so the theta is pi by 2. So the required polar coordinates are half and pi by 2. And if we find this, you also get the same answer. ये दोनों में से हमें कोई भी एक सॉल्व करना है. Now see the next one, that is third one. So 1 and minus root 3. Now see, this point lies in the fourth quadrant where first coordinate is positive and second one is negative. So by comparing this, what is the value of x? X is 1 and y is equals to minus root 3. So we solve this r using the formula and we get it as 2. Now see, x is equals to r cos theta and y is equals to r sin theta. Now put the values, x is equals to 1, r is equals to 2 cos theta, and y is minus root 3 we are given, and r is 2. So by solving we get cos theta is equals to half and sin theta is equals to minus root 3 by 2. ये जो दो इक्वेशंस हमें मिले, ये कोई भी एक हमें सॉल्व करना है. सो वी स्टार्ट फ्रॉम हियर. सो विच एंगल ऑफ कॉस हैविंग वैल्यू माइनस, सॉरी इट इज़ प्लस हाफ, इट इज़ पाई बाय 3 एंड सो कॉस थीटा इज इक्वल्स टू कॉस, नाउ सी पाई बाय 3, सिंस आवर पॉइंट लाइज इन द फोर्थ क्वाड्रेंट. नाउ सी हियर, आई एम गोइंग टू ड्रॉ हियर फिगर. So this is first quadrant, this is second quadrant, this is third quadrant, and this one is the fourth quadrant. Now our point lies in which quadrant? It is in the fourth quadrant, means hamara point yahan pe hai. Theek hai, aapko pata hai all students take coffee means yahan pe all ratios positive hai, yahan pe cos positive hai. Theek hai, so hamara point is quadrant mein hai aur yahan pe jo angle hai wo hum kaise likhte hai, that is 2 pi माइनस थीटा. यू हैव टू कीप इन माइंड दिस ऑल. सो 2 पाई माइनस थीटा लिखना है तो हम कैसे लिखेंगे? सो कॉस 2 पाई माइनस 3, दैट इज पाई बाय 3, यू हैव टू पुट डाउन हियर. एंड सो कॉस इज इक्वल टू टेकिंग एलसीएम वी गेट हियर 5 पाई बाय 3, एंड सो हियर वी गेट द थीटा इज इक्वल टू 5 पाई बाय 3. यहाँ पे हमें ये नहीं लिखना है, अगर हम ऐसा लिखेंगे दैट इज थीटा इज इक्वल टू पाई बाय 3 बाई इक्वेटिंग दिस टू, देन इट विल बी रॉन्ग, बिकॉज थीटा पाई बाय 3 मीन्स 60 एंगल आएगा, बराबर है? लेकिन 60 एंगल फोर्थ क्वाड्रेंट में तो नहीं होता है. सो हमें ये एंगल लिखना है, दैट इज 2 पाई माइनस थीटा. सो ये सॉल्व करते टाइम हमें ये ध्यान रखना है कि पॉइंट कौन से क्वाड्रेंट में है, अगर ये आप भूल जाएंगे तो ये आंसर बराबर नहीं आएगा. नेक्स्ट वन फोर्थ, दैट इज 3 बाय 2 एंड 3 रूट 3 बाय 2. नाउ सी बोथ द पॉइंट्स आर पॉजिटिव, सो द पॉइंट लाइज इन द फर्स्ट क्वाड्रेंट. यू हैव टू पुट इन माइंड दिस वन. सो एक्स इज 3 बाय 2 एंड वाई इज 3 रूट 3 बाय 2. सो इट्स वेरी सिंपल, अगेन यू हैव टू पुट डाउन दिस, वी हैव टू फाइंड दिस आर. सो put the values of x and y. So squaring and taking square root, we get the value of r is 3. Now write down the formulas for x and y. X is equals to r cos theta, y is also r sin theta. So putting this value, that is 3 by 2, 3 here, 3 root 2 by 2 and here 3. So this 3, 3 will get cancelled, we will get cos theta is equals to half, and 3, 3 will get cancelled, so sin theta is equals to root 3 by 2. Two equations hame mile hai, aur hame koi bhi ek solve karna hai, and remember that the point lies in the first quadrant, means 0 to 90 tak ke angle hi hame, isme hi uska answer aana chahiye. So here cos theta is equals to cos pi by 3, because the cos ka pi by 3 means cos 60 half hota hai, so हमने ये रेडियन में लिखा है cos theta is equals to pi by 3 here, so we get theta is equals to pi by 3. So since the point lies in the first quadrant, this answer is correct. See the difference between these two examples. यहाँ पर भी आंसर pi by 3 आया था, that is theta pi by 3, लेकिन हमने ये नहीं लिया था because ये जो पॉइंट है वो फोर्थ quadrant में, फोर्थ quadrant में 60 नहीं रहता है, so हमें 2 pi minus theta हमने ले लिया था, लेकिन यहाँ पे हमारा जो पॉइंट है वो फर्स्ट क्वाड्रेंट में है, एंड सो थीटा इज इक्वल्स टू पाई बाय 3 60 फर्स्ट क्वाड्रेंट में रहता है, एंड सो द आंसर इज थीटा इज इक्वल्स टू पाई बाय 3, एंड सो द रिक्वायर्ड पोलर कोऑर्डिनेट्स आर आर थीटा इज इक्वल्स टू 3 एंड पाई बाय 3. सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 एंड 2 ऑफ द एक्सरसाइज 3.2 ऑफ द ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक फंक्शन. द रिमेनिंग एग्जाम्पल्स विल सी इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर.